60-minute time limit. Introducing first the champion out of Tokyo, Japan. He weighs 254 pounds. Jumbo Tsuruta. Tsuruta. And the challenger out of Quebec City, Quebec, at 234 pounds, Ricky Martel.
Oh ho! Tsuruta drives a right hand to the midsection of Martel, and then a shot to the throat. A reversal, again a reversal. Watch this flying body slam by Martel. A cover, a count of one and two. As Ricky Martel said to me before the match, and as we have relayed on to you, there isn't one particular hole that's going to win it for him. And there you saw an example of that. And it's most likely going to be the same way for Jumbo Tsuruta. The one who wins this one is the one who wears down the other, and then has the big hole there in reserve to end the match. Namalini, there you see Vern Gagne, former heavyweight champion of the world, and what a great champion he was. Martel picks up the champion. Again, two powerful body slams, but he misses an elbow smash. There you see Wally Carbo and Stanley Blackburn looking on. Carbo, promoter of this match. Blackburn, of course, the AWA president out of Amarillo, Texas. Jumbo Tsuruta sensing an injury to Martel's left arm, particularly the elbow, immediately goes to work on it. Jerking away. Applying pressure first one way and then another. The crowd starting to get into the match, wanting to do whatever they can to help Ricky Martel, but they can't help but have just a ton of respect for Jumbo Tsuruta. He is not disliked here tonight. Again, Martel went for an elbow smash. There's an arm drag takedown. That Tsuruta is quick. Martel again went for the elbow smash. See one of the interested spectators and the many, many fans here tonight. That elbow smash attempt by Martel ended up on the top turnbuckle, and it stung. Again, it's the left arm, and again, that's the arm that Jumbo Tsuruta continues to work on. In this match for the AWA Heavyweight Championship of the World, Martel trying to power his way to his feet and break this arm stretching hold of the champion. Pressure in various areas on Martel, not only his neck and shoulder, also the rib cage. The arm is twisted, so there's pressure on the elbow and also the wrist. We say it again. To be in the squared circle, these men have to have the tremendous pain threshold. Quick move by Martel as he is over on top of Jumbo Tsuruta and has a headlock of his own. Martel will not let go. These two men giving it 150%. Tsuruta knows what it's like to be champion. Martel wants to know that feeling in the worst of ways. You can feel the intensity of this match by the look on the faces of those at ringside. Again, Martel refuses to let go as Tsuruta tries to whip him across the ring. The tension of the match carries over into the crowd. That is a powerful, powerful hold that a very strong man, Ricky Martel, has on another very strong man, and you're seeing the strength now of the champion, Jumbo Tsuruta. Look at that. The grim determination of these two as they fight for the heavyweight championship. Tsuruta trying to put Martel down. Martel trying to do the same thing to the champion. Martel wins this time around. Maintains the headlock. What grim determination and courage and valor and strength. You name it. It's on display in the squared circle in this one. Again, Tsuruta will try to power his way out. You hear Martel. What a match! Martel now coming back again. Martel has worked very, very hard for this match, and Tsuruta has too. Both men are going to lose 10, 15 pounds, maybe 20 in this one. Despite the move by Tsuruta, Martel continues to hold on to that headlock. You hear the voice of Leo Namellini. You see the face of Ricky Martel.
What do you say, Jumbo?
The action speaks for itself. Very, very punishing hold here by Martel, as he is in the process of doing, maybe in the process of doing, what he sets out to do, wear the man down. And then be ready with something special when the opportunity presents itself. Oh, what a knee to the face of Ricky Martel, the young man out of Quebec City, Canada. Just about KO'd by that knee to the face as Tsuruta came off the ropes. Martel stunned in the center of the ring. Tsuruta with a forearm. The champion now going to work on the challenger. Another forearm smash. Three of them. And only the best of condition withstand punishment like this. Not only Martel, but Tsuruta as well. Tsuruta setting him up. Is this going to be the pile driver? Down he goes. Martel in deep trouble. The cover, the count. And Vern Gagne was on his feet. Shouting encouragement to Ricky Martel. Once again, the forearm. He winds up from left field and lets it go again. There's the former champion. Look at this. This is the abdominal stretch. One of the tremendously punishing holds of the champion we told you about earlier. One that Ricky Martel said that he had to look out for. Can Martel endure? Nomolini, the referee, in close contact with both men. Tsuruta would like to end it any way possible, and right now by submission if possible. And now it is reversed, as Martel somehow got out and puts on the abdominal stretch of his own. Jumbo Tsuruta inching his way across the ring, has the ropes, and the hold will have to be broken. A parting shot by Martel, a knee to the ribs and an elbow smash to the middle of the back. The body slam by the challenger, a quick cover. Backbreaker by Ricky Martel. Martel now coming over the top rope. Uh-oh, the knees came up and Martel caught it right in the solar plexus. As the flying body slam, one of Martel's favorite moves, and Tsuruta no doubt has looked at film beforehand and was ready for it. Martel has paid the price. Now, souple, down comes Martel, crashing to the canvas. A cover here by the champion, a count of two, but he three. What a match. We have gone past the 20-minute mark. The champion hammering away with forearms to the middle of the back. Martel firing away, trying to drill his man with his own forearm smashes. They both go down in that collision at the center of the ring. Nomolini, the referee, counting. That's five. Jumbo Tsuruta first to regain his feet, but Martel quickly thereafter. Wow, a drop kick to the middle of the back of Martel by Tsuruta sent Martel crashing into Leo Nomolini, and he is stunned. There is the souple backdrop for a one count, maybe it was two. Now Tsuruta shoves referee Leo Nomolini, and Mr. Nomolini will be admonishing the champion for that, I would guess. But the action goes on, and a reversal and a whip. And now Tsuruta coming across, but Tsuruta has run into the top rope. And here is a flying power body slam, a count of one, a count of two, a count of three, and the new heavyweight champion of the world out of Quebec City, Canada, is Ricky Martel. Ricky Martel, absolutely delirious. As Tsuruta was stunned as he came across the ring and came crashing down.
Heavyweight champion of the world, Ricky Martel.
Tsuruta came crashing down on that top rope with his throat. He was stunned. He was on the canvas. Martel lined him up for the flying, the running body slam, which he does. And there he has the championship belt. which he has wanted so very, very badly, and has won from a very, very game champion of the world, Jumbo Tsuruta.